Now, which was the finding of Pareto? It was that the distribution of incomes is very long-tailed, that the probability of income exceeding value u is roughly of the form u to the power minus some exponent alpha. This in contrast with the distribution in physics, which are very often exponential, exponential of minus alpha of u, or even Gaussian, that is exponential of minus of u squared. Therefore, high income's probability goes down much more slowly than the probability of many of the physical phenomena. Which was the fate of Pareto distribution of the long period between its description in, say, 1900 and the time it became involved in the early 60s? I would say that it was a mixture of neglect and scorn. There was a certain number of authors did test the data, found distribution to be correct, and followed a little bit in defending it. But by and large, the argument was that was a rule without any logic behind it, any kind of explanation, and that it did not deserve attention, and that another distribution called lognormal was much preferable. To say that distribution of income is lognormal is to say the logarithm of income is normal, Gaussian. To say that the distribution of income is power law is to say that lognormal is exponentially distributed. Now, exponential and the Gaussian are not that terribly different. They're very different, but not that terribly different. What is very striking is that once you go back to u from log u, enormous differences appear from viewpoint of this essential feature, which is economic inequality. So perhaps I should follow up first on this matter of economic inequality and contrast three possibilities, which would be a distribution that's power law, and distribution that's log normal, distribution that's Gaussian, and perhaps even distribution that is exponential. Imagine, as I like to say, as an example, two persons picked in the street, preferably on Wall Street, and you have a way of having their total income, which happens to be 2 million. Well, everybody has a very strong feeling that if the total is 2 million, it is not because each of them had 1 million plus or minus some factor, because one had a normal income and the other had all the rest, roughly 2 million. Therefore, we have a very strong feeling that economic variables are unequal. If you make sum of two variables, there is one which is larger, which predominates if the sum is larger. If you did that for exponential random variable, you would find no inequality, evenness. For a Gaussian random variable, each would pick one half and plus or minus a term. The Gaussian being characteristic of physical phenomena, it is very important to observe that physical phenomena, except near the critical points, are not subjected to great influence of individual observations. What Pareto law was tackling is the fact that economical phenomena, like income, are not that uniformly distributed, and was coming very close to the core of the problem. Again, what would be the case if the distribution of income were lognormal, which many people proclaimed to be the case? Well, if two persons together had an income of 2 million, then indeed one of them would have a normal income and the other a very large income. The lognormal distribution also has the property of being very unequal for small samples like two.